All right, what's up, everyone? I started hiking earlier today about, I don't know, 10 o'clock or so. I've been hiking for a little bit, and that's one of the prettiest streams I've ever seen. That's amazing. Anyway, it's gonna be a good day. Weather, went got down like 40 last night. It's probably close to 50 right now, 55. It feels good. Nice little breeze. Sun is, it's gonna warm the water up and the fish can start eating. Let's go see if we can find them. Can't tell, but that looks like a dead bull trout right there. You never know, it could have been natural causes, but who knows. Big fish though. Dude, come on. Jeez. Brother, you're killing me. I hear you. Let's just let you go here. Since this is where you want to be. Stop, stop, stop. Probably gonna be one of those quick. Yep, he's trying to jump already. Calm down. All right. Okay, guess I'll just stay right out here and fish. I checked my lead and everything. I had him back there where I wanted him, and then he had a sudden burst of energy. Went back where he wanted to go.
Oh,
that was the fish.
Saw a fish rise up there. So let's go up there close. I have tried stoneflies, caddis, micro leeches, trying a lot of different things. This is kind of a pertagon, but it doesn't have the telling fiber, so basically just a zebra midge. Sings fast. Caught a bunch the other day, trying to replenish some of the stuff. I just didn't feel like adding telling material and all that stuff. I just didn't need it. I don't feel like the fish care that much about if it has tail or it just looks buggy and it sinks and gets down. Couldn't get my hands around it. It was a good fish. Oh no. Damn it. This is what happens when you're trying to mess with the camera. Dude, come on. No chance of getting that out. Damn it. This is part of the frustrations of running a camera, trying to fish, trying to show the everything's going on. Sometimes you get a little things on go the way you want them to go. So alright, I'm re-rigged. I'm gonna show you guys what I was using. It was basically a pheasant tail, but I was using ostrich hurl for the thorax. I think it gives it a little bit of movement, a little breathing, I guess you would say. Fish seem to like it, but only had a couple of them, and I've already lost them, so. Oh, well. Just going with a regular old pheasant tail right now. What a great eat. Maybe I can show you guys this fish. Maybe not break everything off. Getting down will be the challenge. You're too safe. Okay. Let's see if I can catch another one. Show you the flies real quick. So everybody's familiar with the Fat Albert. Just a big, big hopper. I don't do anything fancy with the legs. I don't think fish really care. And then just this little, call it a pheasant tail, like a little olive. I think I was using some soft tackle off of a partridge, but keep working that little seam right there where it comes off that rock. Went about 7 feet down.
Man, B. I didn't realize I'd gone as far, but it took me almost 2 hours to hike out. It's almost six now. I left about four. I knew it was gonna take me a little bit of time because I was in the stream all day and I didn't really get out and look, but it was a pretty hike out, but man, it took me a while. Pretty much all I got for today. Man, what a special stream. I don't really find a prettier stream than that. And then full of cutthroat, that's just, man, definitely fortunate to be here. Pretty much gonna hang out here the rest of the night, do some dinner, be really low-key, gonna take it easy, and maybe think about where to go next. Just a fun couple of days here, but I wanna see a couple other things, and that's pretty much all I got. If you haven't already, check the description for a link to the playlist that has the road trip. Started out in Wyoming, then I went to Idaho, and now I'm in Montana. Been a really, really fun trip. Hope you guys are enjoying it. I need to sit down and get off my feet. I'm exhausted, man.